Hi, lunatics. Here we are back in Blighty. This is the milk moon, the panther moon, the planting moon, and the dragon moon. Yeah, I forgot that. I'm just back from Holland. We had an amazing elders meeting over there, and they were just back from trips to Korea, and they'd gone to North Korea, South Korea, and China, and were hoping to open up the negotiations because they'd broken down a long time ago, and there's been a sinking of a ship, a southern ship by the north, and things are getting quite tense as there is potential for nuclear war over there. But there's also been terrible crops and a real food shortage up in the north, and I think they managed to open up negotiations. In fact, they were just leaving a little depressed and then were told to come back to the house that they were staying in. And they there received a message from a great leader that there was a willingness to open negotiations both with South Korea and the US on all sorts of subjects. So it was a fantastic result. And I think one of the best examples for the outside world of the work and the potential power that the elders can have. They then went straight away to the Ivory Coast, and there managed to see the new president and the deposed president, who was not hanging on to power, but they went to see him in jail too. And I think one of the great things about Tutu's experience is that he set up the Truth and Reconciliation Committee in South Africa, and people then were able to sort of go through their experiences and the horrors, and often start the process of reconciliation and forgiveness. Not everyone is able to do that, but in terms of healing a nation that has been falling in on itself, and it's enormously effective, and I think they were very helpful in that department. One of the really interesting visits was to the International Criminal Court, and I'm an enormous fan of the ICC. I think it's one of the most important creations of my lifetime, in the sense that it says that there are horrors of genocide and murder of people, rape, and when these perpetrators have been able to get away with it and remain unpunished in the past, there is now an institution that can make sure that justice is brought to bear and some of these criminals can be pulled up in front of the courts. And national sovereignty, which I think in a lot of these areas is the enemy, has been the excuse to prevent anyone going in and grabbing these people or bringing them to justice. Now, they can only work in the countries that have signed on, but hopefully there will be some pressure, as we've seen just recently, with Libya, where the Security Council very quickly, unanimously, asked for Gaddafi to be brought before the International Criminal Court, or at least investigated by the court. And yet, some of the Security Council haven't actually signed on to the or ratified the treaty creating the International Criminal Court. So we hope that'll happen. I know many of you are uninterested by all this stuff, but we also had a wonderful time in our visit because we were being hosted by Queen Beatrix of Holland, who is our CEO's mother-in-law. But she gave us the run of three palaces for the meetings, or entertained us. And on one afternoon, after lunch, they got out 10 horse-drawn carriages with footmen and took us all through the woods. So it was we were well pampered, and that was very nice. But it's great actually to see that the elders now are getting much more respect for the work that they do. And the Prime Minister turned out, and it's fantastic to see it all working. Anyway, they came back, and we've been checking in on how the film is going. Blue Leach, who's been directing the 3D film from Hammersmith has been busy working on both the 3D version and the 2D version, which have their own different personality and different editors too. But I think they're coming along quite well. And Tiki and Richard Sharrett have been doing a fantastic job on the sound mixing. And when I go and see it in London with not very good sound, and then I go and see it down in the studios at Real World, and the sound is fantastic. It's a big difference, and I think it's already sounding better than it did in real life, which is the magic of mixing. And the editing too is looking good, so I'm happy with that. A while back, I sent in my votes for the International Songwriting Competition, which is based in Nashville. And although there's still, I think, an American slant to the material, I think it is a very important thing, and they're opening things up. They have sort of dance and electronica, they have a world music section, and a folk music section, which I voted on as well. In fact, there was, I think, my favorite song there, which is Cold Paper Heart. If any of you interested in songwriting, it's a I think, very good song, great lyric. I love the art of songwriting. That's really what got me into music in the first place, that and then drumming. And I hope at some point to get more involved with trying to champion people to think about songwriting a little more, because just as much as playing, there's a real art to it, and something you can learn, and you can listen to the masters and learn a few tricks from them. So I hope one day we'll be able to do something with that. I've always wanted to see a sort of songwriters festival, which we may try and do around WOMAD, but that's in the future, just riffing at the moment. I think the Al Jazeera interview that I did with Riz Khan was shown this month too. I've known him a while too, and he's been asking for an interview, and we got round to it in Davos in the end, and he's good at putting you at your ease and going through history and current stuff. So I think that'll be on the website. And as I mentioned before, you know, I was very inspired meeting their director general, because I think they're doing really interesting things and are in many ways underpinning the Arab Spring, or the revolution that's going on over there. I've also been following the story of Ai Weiwei, the amazing Chinese artist and sculptor, who's actually got a couple of things opening in London this week, or they've just opened, in fact, one at Somerset House. And he's extraordinary man who's completely unafraid, and says whatever he thinks and feels about life in China. It's appalling what's happened to him. His studio was taken down, and he's been in prison several times, but it disappeared. And I heard today, in fact, that his wife had been allowed to visit him for the first time, so she knows he's alive and being looked after, so that's good. As you might have guessed, I'm a strong campaigner for human rights, and I do absolutely believe there are universal values which and basic freedoms to which everyone is entitled, regardless of what country or what culture or what religion they're born in. It is interesting to have this argument sometimes with the Chinese, who would say to the Americans that from when they got independence in 1776, it took them a very long time to decide to give women the vote, to decide to give blacks the vote, and they're going to put things right in a lot shorter space of time. But they are terrified of things that disrupt what they would call social harmony, and that they put that at a higher premium than individual rights or freedoms. I completely disagree with that, but it is interesting sometimes to hear the other point of view. Again, another Chinese friend told me of a park in Shanghai that used to have a sign on it saying no dogs or Chinese, and this was when the English were there. So, and we didn't do too well because, you know, one of our main industries really was drug running and the opium trade, from which we made a lot of money, along with the slave trade. So that was, I think karma is another question. Anyway, I'm sure a lot of you just want to find out about the music, and the music's going really well, as I mentioned in the film, and looking forward to coming out to America in June. I know the tickets have been an issue, and in fact I wrote to all the promoters and they've kindly sent letters explaining what's happened and their position in regard to tickets, and I will be putting those up on the website. Please, if you want to know that the prices are controlled by through our website, and or at least compare prices on our website with anyone else you're considering buying tickets from, because there we have a chance to keep them controlled. And anyway, I think, yeah, for those of you that I haven't explained the show to, it the whole thing is with orchestra. It says no guitars, no drums, and there is some percussion, in fact, but what I mean is it's not a traditional band show, and you won't get the sort of sledgehammer. It's not a traditional Gabriel show in that way. I think it's really interesting and really exciting, and most people that have come have been very satisfied. So I hope you do check it out. It's something different. I think these are sort of contemporary arrangements, but they're beautiful and musical, and we have wonderful players with us. So I think you'll be in for a treat. I hope to see some of you out there, and for everyone else, have a wonderful month, and I hope to see you at the next full moon. Take care. And the track we've got a bit of an extract from today is Mercy Street. This was also the song which had a beautiful black and white Matt Mahern video, and in fact we're still using some of those images in the live show, as I think there's some of the favorite images that have been created to my stuff. It's very moody, atmospheric, and I hope you like it.
Here we go, folks, this is a tape. Nice and quiet.
Beautiful.